Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I've got a ton of DIY fun stuff and recipes coming up for you, so make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on that little bell notification. Today we're gonna do some cute little planter hanging thing. I'm not quite sure what this is, but I found it at Goodwill, so let's get to it. First thing, I'm gonna clean it because it's really dirty. Not quite sure if it's supposed to be a mailbox, inbox holder for, I don't know what it is. But I thought it'd be cute with flowers in it. I don't even know what material this is. Also, I'm gonna cut this string. I don't really like it as a hanger, so I'm just gonna cut that off. Now that it's clean, we're gonna just give it a quick sand to get any scuffs or any, you know, existing paint off. Just this little sanding block. I don't know what grit it is. I've just had it forever. This will help the paint adhere better and also kind of give it more of a distressed look, which is what I like. It's also getting a lot of extra scuffs off. I'm not gonna worry too much about the inside because we're gonna fill that with dirt and flowers, but I am gonna give it a quick once over just so it looks good. You wanna make sure to get the bottom sanded as well because it will be hanging, so you're gonna see it. All right, so now that that is done, shake it up. I'm gonna wipe it down one more time and get all the little grainies off of it. Grainies is a technical term. Now that that is done, we're gonna mix up our paint. And since I'm gonna use kind of brighter flowers, bright red, bright orange, I wanted to keep this more neutral. So I have vintage white, which is pretty close to the color it already is, but I'm gonna mix it with some bright white just to kind of brighten it up. And these are just multi-surface acrylic paint, nothing too fancy. And I'm just gonna do a quick coat of paint, and like I said earlier, I like the kind of distressed rustic look, so if it's not 100% perfect, I'm okay with that. Just want it a little bit brighter. Don't wanna paint my countertops. I don't think my landlord would approve. So I'm not being super particular about this edge scroll, making sure every little corner is painted. I kind of like it with a little bit of the original yellowish color peeking through just to kind of maintain that, the rustic kind of weathered look. All right, I'm just doing the finishing touches now, and then we're just gonna let it dry because I think it looks pretty good just for the first coat. Alright, so our first coat of paint dried nice, and I actually think we're just gonna do one coat, kind of like the color that it turned out, and how it's still a little bit with like the original color, but not so dingy yellow. Got some Miracle-Gro potting soil here that'll help the plants kind of take off and thrive. I'm just gonna literally try to not be as messy as I am, but it's gonna be messy, and just fill down here with potting soil. I mean, it's dirt. There's no clean way to do this. That should be enough there. I like, we need more. All right, so I have these two flowers. Got them at Home Depot. I loved the color, so I don't know if I'll be able to use both, but we're gonna try and find out. Both of them like a lot of sunlight and are great in containers and attract butterflies and hummingbirds and all sorts of cute little creatures, which I like to see. So we're just gonna like gently shimmy this out of its container and break it up a little bit so that way it fits better in the container and also kind of loosens up the roots a little bit as well. There was a slug. These poor plants, I feel so bad. Squishing the roots. You probably can't see, but inside I'm just kind of breaking off more of the loose dirt so it sits down nicer in there. Okay. I really like this one because I like the idea that it'll kind of trail and it'll grow down and kind of turn into a big, almost bush looking thing. And that'll be really pretty. I'm gonna add a little bit more soil on top, give it some water, and clean her off. Now I'm just kind of cleaning off all the extra dirt that got everywhere. And there she is. You thought we were done, but we're not. I have Mr. T, you're gonna get mud everywhere now. Like with a cat. Alright, now we're just gonna put these through. Think about it. I see you staring. Just tie it up. That didn't work. Let's try it this way. Triple, triple. There we go. Oh my god! Here we have our finished DIY planter. Make sure you like and subscribe and hit the little bell for notifications on all of our future DIY projects and recipes to come. Thanks for watching!